the utility group. And the judge for the utility group is Mr. Bob Gregory. Please welcome him into the ring. Bob Gregory is escorted into the ring by Mr. Bill Hardaway, Vice Chairman of the Kennel Club. Bob Gregory began judging in 1974 and first awarded CCs in 1979. Since then, he has been approved to award CCs in 25 breeds across the utility, working, and pastoral groups, and best in show at championship level. His overseas appointments have taken him to 4 continents and 15 countries. Mr. Bob Gregory. And we lead in with the Akita. The Boston Terrier. The Bulldog. The Canaan Dog. The Chow Chow. The Dalmatian. The French Bulldog. The German Spitz Klein. The German Spitz Mittel. The Japanese Shiba Inu. The Japanese Spitz. The Keeshond. The Lhasa Apso. The Miniature Schnauzer. The Miniature Poodle. The Standard Poodle. The Toy Poodle. The Schipperke. The Schnauzer. The Shar Pei. The Shih Tzu. The Tibetan Spaniel. And finally, the Tibetan Terrier. I hand you over now to Graham Hill for the commentary.
Thank you, David. Ladies and gentlemen, as we move to the end of the second day of Crufts 2005, we come to the fourth group to be judged, the utility group. The second group on the second day of Crufts, leaving 3 more groups to be judged over tomorrow and Sunday. That's before we arrive at the semi-finals, the best in show judging on Sunday evening. The utility group is made up of breeds, as you can see, of all shapes and sizes. As the description utility denotes, there are breeds of having several functions or uses. They range from companion dogs to guarding dogs. As we come to each of the individual best of breeds, you will understand why they have been grouped under the utility heading. There were 2,755 utility dogs entered here today. All entered in their respective breeds. We now see in the ring the 23 best breeds selected from the overall entry. As is common practice, you see our judge, Mr. Bob Gregory, moving along. And the first appraisal of all the breeds we have here in the utility group. It's worth noting that within this group there are no vulnerable breeds. possibly their most breeds originate from overseas. I think the Bulldog being the only indigenous breed to Great Britain. And the first breed to see close to Great Britain is the Akita. The breed was judged today by Mr. J. Killerly, and she received an entry of 111 dogs. And she selected this bitch for best of breed, exhibit number 7752. The Akita is the most popular breed in his native Japan. A breed which is large, upstanding, dignified. This is the Akita. The Akita Inu, being a large dog, Japanese traces its origins back many centuries to the polar regions, from where six white dogs found their way to the northern mountainous areas of Japan. The Akita emerged some 300 years ago and was developed originally as a fighting dog. It was diverted to hunting for black bear, wild boar, and deer. Now we move to the table where we see the Boston Terrier. Breed judge today is Mrs. V. Tanner. It was an entry of 71, where she selected this male as her best breed, exhibit number 7869. The Boston Terrier is a real Yankee little dandy. It's one of the few breeds made in the USA. The Boston Terrier. It was in 1893 that a mix of bull and terrier types produced the first pair of dogs, which were to become the foundation of the Boston Terrier. The breed is good-tempered, the happy household. Only a little boisterous. Its short coat is easy to care for, and its sense of intelligence is highly developed. That's the Boston Terrier. And next on the floor of the ring, we see the Bulldog. Mr. C. Newman was the breed judge. And there was an entry of 186. And from it, she selected this bitch, exhibit number 7991. The Bulldog is one of the oldest indigenous breeds, known as the National Dog of Great Britain, and is associated throughout the world with British determination and the legendary John Bull. The breed was used originally for bull baiting, and the Bulldog also fought its way through the dog pits. But in 1835, the band began to evolve into the short-faced squat version we now know. This is the Bulldog. The Bulldog re-entered the show in 1860, and the ensuing years saw a big personality change. The breed's mood is dignified, humorous, or comical, with many endearing characteristics. The Bulldog. Switching on to the Canaan Dog. Miss EFD Williams was the breed judge, and she selected this dog for best of breed, exhibit number 8128. The Canaan Dog, a recent reintroduction to the United Kingdom, is generally accepted as the national dog of Israel. A few have been registered here in the past decade, but it's only in the last few years that the breed has begun to be exhibited at our shows. Here we see the Canaan Dog. The Canaan Dog is one of the few breeds exhibited here in Crufts, which do not have held a chance to do that on offer. He's an effective guarding golden dog, alert, versatile, and is a medium size, standing up to 61 centimeters in the shoulder. The
Canaan Dog.
Now we see the Chow Chow. Just as he welcomes the prejudge from entry 19, he selected his catcher's best degree, exhibit number 8171. Chow Chow's ancestry is attributed to China. When he was kept as a guard dog, was also used for hunting. He made his way to the United Kingdom sometime during the late 18th century. Next, we see the Dalmatian. This is J.A. Swindles, the breed judge. And there are 232 dogs present today. From those dogs, you select this male, exhibit number 8430. The Dalmatian is a dog with a very distinctive appearance, being either black spotted or liver spotted. The spots standing out well in a pure white background color of his coat. As a puppy, he's born pure white, making it impossible to know whether his spots will be black or liver. This is the Dalmatian. The breed is very popular during the Regency period. It's known as the carriage dog. It was used to run ahead of all types of carriages. Also used to run ahead of horse-drawn fire engines in London, earning himself the name of Firehouse Dog. That's the Dalmatian. Now on the table we see the French Bulldog. This is a category of the green judge and around 108 dogs present here for us. From those dogs you select this. Male has best degree in exhibit number 8467. The French Bulldog is a compactly built dog who, in spite of his name, is believed to be at least partly of British origin. It is said that English lace makers took a toy bulldog type dog with them when they went to work in France. This was used as a short-faced bull baiting dog from other European countries to produce French bulldogs as we know it. This is the French Bulldog. French Bulldog first came to England around 1900, with the French Bulldog Club being formed in 1903. The breed is known to be very intelligent, always ready for fun, known to have a affectionate disposition. That's the French Bulldog. German Spitz Klein. This is H.C. Gillies, judge degree, and selected this male as best degree, exhibit number 8585, from an entry of 79. German Spitz Klein is the smaller of the two German Spitz varieties I'll show you today at Crufts. I'm introduced to the Kennel Club's list of breeds. Relatively recent introduction to the United Kingdom. German Spitz Klein should measure between 9 inches and 11.5 inches, or 23 centimeters and 29 centimeters of shoulder. This is the German Spitz Klein. independent parent with a happy outlook on life. It's a harsh outer coat coupled with its thick undercoat insulates him against all weathers. That's the German Spitz Klein. Now we move to the larger version of the German Spitz Mittel. The green is a game judge by Mrs. H.C. Hillies. There were 103 entries, and from the entries, she selected this male, exhibit number 8687, as best of green. As I said, this is the second of the two varieties of German Spitz, the German Spitz Mittel. Larger than the Klein, the Mittel stands between 12 and 15 inches, or 30 and 38 centimeters in shoulder. Similar in many ways, characteristics as the Klein. It obviously has the same origin. Native of Germany. This is the German Spitz Mittel. The Mittel is identical in shape and characteristics to the Klein. What a difficult breed to maintain. As long as his grooming is regular and very thorough. This breed makes an ideal pet. Quite capable of living with old and young alike. The German Spitz Mittel. Named David ago, who is the Japanese Shiba Inu. Mr. C. Thomas was the green judge. Selected 8752, this is Lynch, was best degree from which 102. The Japanese Shiba Inu is a relatively newcomer to the United Kingdom, arriving here from Japan. He's a very alert dog, always gives the impression of being interested in everything going on around him. See the Japanese Shiba Inu. Shiba Inu is a Japanese sitting dog. She is originated in the mountains of the areas of Japan. We use a sitting dog mainly a ground game, and sometimes for a larger game like wild boar and deer. Size and thick head scope makes an ideal pet. That's the Japanese Shiba Inu. Now we see the Japanese Spitz. This is Kay Forster's judge today. And from the entry 64, she selected this male as best of breed, exhibit number 8858. The Japanese Spitz is yet another of the growing number of Spitz breeds being seen here in the United Kingdom. This is a lap-sized Spitz type breed descending from Nordic long-haired dogs. He was taken to Japan early in the 20th century after its arrival there was meant to produce its size, to that which you see here today. Starting by coat, bold, affectionate nature, make him an attractive household pet. The Japanese Spitz. And now we see the case one. This was an AO exhibit number 8895. 74 Keeshond present here, and Mr. G.W. Liston is the green judge. The Keeshond is also known as the Dutch barge dog. Keeshond taking its name from the Dutch patriot, Cornelis de Gazelle, who was nicknamed Keys. His dog became a symbol of the Dutch patriot party, His Highness the Canaan Dog. Keeshond is a typically prickly and curly-tailed spitz, full of activity and occasionally of noise. He's a good-natured guard dog and quite capable of letting visitors know that their arrival has been detected. Then all too ready to greet them as a lot more strength. That's the Keeshond. Now we see on the table the Lhasa Apso. Torrance is the green judge, with an entry of 202. His male selected as best of green, exhibit number 8978. His green comes from Tibet, where many lives at high altitudes and where the climate is severe. The Apso is one of several eastern breeds to come to the west. First arriving in Britain in the early 1920s, and were confused with other shaggy oriental dogs. They were labeled Lhasa Terriers. In the green movies, the miniature Schnauzer. The miniature Schnauzer's handy size make this a popular attack dog. They are robust, hardy, and agile. They are very alert and can always warn of the approach of strangers to their property. Here we see the Miniature Poodle. Fuse coat requires regular grooming, but on the plus side, Fuse coat does not shed. That's the Miniature Poodle. And now we move on to the Standard Poodle. The breed was scheduled to be judged by Mrs. J.V. Freeman, but unfortunately she was taken ill, so Mr. Darren Smith completed the judging of the breed today. There were 180 entered, and this bishop selected his best of breed for exhibit numbers 9421. The Standard Poodle, somewhat larger than its miniature cousin, is required to be over 38 centimeters high on the shoulder. This is a dog for the fashion conscious. So coat being clipped in many different styles. Here we see the Standard Poodle. The most common cuts being the lamb cut and the lion cut, which we see here in the ring today. Coat styles being derived from those cuts, and the poodle was used for its job of work, being well established as a water retriever. The larger size of poodle being used by the French as a duck dog, the Standard Poodle. Smallest poodles, the toy poodle. The breed was judged today by Mrs. C. Hopsel, and there was an entry of 117, from which she selected this bitch, exhibit number 9653. The shape and characteristics of the toy poodles are just like its larger cousins, with its height. The shoulder should be under 11 inches or 28 centimeters. This is the toy poodle. These smaller poodles also had and could do a job of work. It's understood that they were used in their French Open to sniff out truffles. The breed generally are clowns by nature and give amusement and devotion to their owners. They are real dandies at heart. Sporting home loving instincts and like to make it the ideal companion, the toy poodle. And now we see the Schipperke. Dr. Jay Sampson was the breed judge. There was an entry of 82. He selected this male. His best of breed, exhibit number 9703. Schipperke is one of the smallest Spitz breeds, a very compact breed which originates from the canals of Belgium and Holland. This is where the yard of the barge is most efficiently. It has the ability to detect and deter strangers, which makes it a very good household. Associated with Holland and Belgium. He comes from the province known as Flanders, where at one time the breed was extremely popular with shoemakers. On Sundays they were paraded out and about by the tradesmen. It was in 1690 that the Schipperke had the first one breed show put on by the Guild of Shoemakers, the Schipperke. Is the middle-sized member of the Schnauzer family. A breed suitable for those who want something a little larger than the miniature, but not quite as big as the giant. Schnauzer is a lively nature. He's a good house dog, a good guard dog, and enjoys obedience work. This is the Schnauzer. This is a breed known in the USA as the standard Schnauzer. The home country for the Schnauzer is Germany, where the standard version is used on many roles. Ratter, drover's dog, top tender, and guard in the house of stables. That's the Schnauzer. Spaniel. This is Lee Armstrong's breed judge. There's an entry of 177 here at Crufts 2005. This male is best of breed. His exhibit number is 10161. The Tibetan Spaniel is one of the first Tibetan breeds to reach Britain, coming here in around 1900. Favoured by the Tibetan monks, and was brought back to Britain by returning medical missionaries. The Tibetan Spaniel. This breed is a delightful temperament. Haughty expression, but only too ready to let his hair down and a man rush about the garden with friend and family. This breed likes human company. He'll do with all the exercise and makes devoted family pet. This is the Tibetan Spaniel. Finally, we see the last breed of the utility group, the Tibetan Terrier. This is Yves Kurzler as the breed judge. There's an entry of 200. And she said this male has best breed, exhibit number 10483. spite of the terrier title in his name, this breed is not a terrier, but a herding dog, doubling as a guide for trainers as they journeyed to and from China. The Chow Chow. The German Spitz Klein. The Japanese Shiba Inu. The Lhasa Apso. The Miniature Poodle. The Standard Poodle. Shih Tzu and the Tibetan Terrier. There we have our shortest event. We'll shake hands with the other exhibitors as they leave the room. Please give them a warm round of applause for their achievement today here at Crufts 2005. Klein. Exhibit number 8585. Now we see the Lhasa Apso, exhibit number 8978. The Miniature Poodle. Exhibit number 1314. Now we see the Standard Poodle. Exhibit number 9421. Now the Shih Tzu. Exhibit number 9992. And finally, the Tibetan Terrier. Exhibit number 10483. Just another quick move for the Tibetan Terrier. Another quick look at Chow Chow, German Spitz Klein, Japanese Shiba Inu, Lhasa Apso, Miniature Poodle, Standard Poodle, Shih Tzu, Tibetan Terrier. Which one will it be? The winner of the utility group is the Japanese Shiba Inu. Exhibit number 8752. We do. The Miniature Poodle, exhibit number 9314. Group 3, the Shih Tzu, exhibit number 9992. And group 4, the German Spitz Klein, exhibit number 8585. Grammy goes, shake the other shoulders to the reporters and to the lady in the ring. And I ask you also to give them a warm applause, congratulating them on their achievements in Crufts 2005. Crufts 2005. Reverend reflected in the life of Japanese Shiba Inu. The presentation of the Send Gold Vase will be made by Mr. Peter Newman, led into the ring by Mr. Hardaway, Vice Chairman of the Canaan Dog. I see there will be no strangers to those jockey people amongst you. A very successful breeder, exhibitor, many years standing. So to recap, the winner of the utility group Crufts 2005 is the Japanese Shiba Inu, exhibit number 8752. Group 2, the Miniature Poodle, exhibit number 9314. Group 3, the Shih Tzu, exhibit number 9992. Four, the German Spitz Klein, exhibit number 8585. I'm sure the winners will have to go around the honor for us, just so that you can show your appreciation and congratulate them on their win at Eurasier 2005. And ask them to go around the ring.